Worship leaders, you're probably familiar with Planning Center. One of my favorite features of Planning Center is Planning Center Live, which allows you to track exactly how long different elements of your service are. Hey, this is Will Doggett. Today I want to show you how to use Ableton Live to control Planning Center Live so that you don't have to have someone sit behind a computer and press spacebar. So let's get started. Okay, so let's talk about how to make this happen. So you could technically do this on the same computer, but most likely, I'm assuming you probably are doing this on separate machines. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. On this machine, I've got Ableton Live, and on this machine, I've got Planning Center Live opened up. And I'm using a really cool app called Bome MIDI Translator Pro to convert a MIDI note from Ableton Live to spacebar, to basically press spacebar and change elements in Planning Center Live. Now, to make this easy for you, I have a free template that you can download both with a MIDI cue in Ableton Live and the Bome MIDI Translator preset. You're gonna have to purchase Bome in order to make that happen, but you can download the preset for Ableton and for Bome MIDI Translator Pro and open it up and get going right away. Okay, before I show you how I did that in Bome MIDI Translator Pro, first, I want to talk about connecting the machine. So I'm doing this with two different machines. I could make this a wired connection or wireless connection. For the sake of this video, I'm doing this wirelessly. Now, typically, I don't suggest using or controlling things wirelessly in a live performance, but because this is a pretty kind of low stress thing, if this goes down, it's probably not the end of the world. I think wireless would likely be fine, but even what I'm showing you now could be applied to a wired network. And I've linked to the video below in the description that shows you how to do this wirelessly as well. So the way I'm gonna do this is using the built-in RTP MIDI network that's included in every Mac for free. So I'm gonna hit Spotlight here and search for Audio MIDI Setup. Make sure you go up to Window and do Show MIDI Studio. If you're on Mojave, you will not see the network icon show up here that you're used to seeing. So you can hit the globe icon to show network MIDI. What I want to do is make sure I have at least one session created on my computer, make sure that Who May Connect Me is set to anyone, and make sure I have a bonjour name in this area. So in my directory, I see from Studio Stage 2, which is this machine. So what I'm gonna do is click on that machine and hit connect. Now again, both of these are on the same wireless network, which is how I saw them. For some reason you don't see your machine, one, make sure Who May Connect Me is set to anyone. Two, make sure there's a bonjour name listed. Three, it's possible you might have a firewall set up between those. In that case, talk to someone, your local IT professional at the gig, at the venue, at your church. To help you figure that out. You could also do an ad hoc network if you know what that means and know how to set that up. So in this case, I've got my session created here. I've connected to the same session on this computer. Once I connect here, it's showing up automatically. So I'm not even gonna open that. Let's go into Ableton and talk about the couple settings we need there in Ableton. So I'm using this template again that I created that you can get for free. I'll share the link with how to get that here in a moment. You can get that for free. Basically all it is a MIDI clip that has a MIDI note in it. It's set to use network session one. You could change it to however you're connected. And it's set to channel 16. The other thing I did here, because I'm using the network connection, I hit command comma, which is gonna take me into preferences. I'm gonna click link MIDI. And on the output side of this, I wanna go to network session one. I wanna make sure that track is enabled. That's gonna allow me to send MIDI from Ableton Live's tracks to the network RTP MIDI network session down to this machine. So with this template open, with that connection made, with both of these computers connected, let's go over to our Planning Center Live computer. So on this machine, I've got Planning Center Live open. Make sure that you click Take Control to take control of the service so that you can control it. And essentially the way the control of Planning Center Live works is you hit spacebar and you go to the next element in your set. So super easy, super straightforward. So let's go back to our previous element, to the start. So we haven't started our service yet. Now I've got Bome MIDI Translator Pro again installed on this computer. I've loaded the free template. Again, stick around to hear the URL to download this for free. So all it's doing is just taking this MIDI note in Ableton Live that it receives, and it's converting that MIDI note, you can see here, to spacebar. So that essentially all it's doing is just pressing spacebar when I'm over in Planning Center Live. And in Bome MIDI Translator Pro, what I did is I went to my project default MIDI ports, and I just selected it as my input network session one. You can see that port is open and it's ready to go. So let's try this out and see what happens. So I'm gonna go into Safari with Planning Center Live open, Then I'm gonna go back over to Ableton. I'm just gonna trigger my MIDI clip. So again, what happens is it's gonna send the MIDI note to Network Session 1, to Bome MIDI Translator Pro, just gonna convert it to spacebar, and then I'm virtually pressing spacebar. So you can see it switched. Let's hit spacebar again to start it. You see it goes to the next one, spacebar again, it goes to the next one. So how do we practically use this? So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna open a new live set here, and we're gonna pretend that this is a set full of a couple of different songs. So I'm gonna add just a couple different locators, just like I would if I was running tracks for an actual service. So I've got four songs set up. And then using my browser, I'm gonna go and navigate to where I have that template stored on my computer. Okay, so I'm gonna click the arrow to the left of the live project, the arrow to the left of the live set, and then finally the arrow to the left of the live track. And what that gives me is just that go clip. So what I'm gonna do is just drop this in, and I'm gonna have it drop in at the beginning of my song, the beginning of my next song, and then finally my fourth song here. Okay, to clean this setup, I'm gonna go through and delete my extra MIDI and audio tracks. And then the final thing I need to do is make sure my routing is correct here. So I'm gonna change this to Network Session 1. And again, this is programmed to use channel 16. So with this plugged in, I'm pretty much ready to go. So now hands-free, I can press spacebar to start Ableton's playback. And you'll see as I hit that clip at specific times in my set, it's gonna press spacebar and essentially toggle to the next song. A couple things about this. One, I can't assign a specific cue here to a specific song in Planning Center Live. So if you've heard me talk about this before, there's two types of programming, absolute and relative. This is an example of relative programming. We're not saying this cue goes to Glorious Day or this cue goes to song three. We just say this cue goes to spacebar, which triggers our next song. It's not the greatest thing in the world, but that's how Planning Center Live works, and it works just fine for what we are doing. So a couple things to be aware of. There's a little bit of delay when you press spacebar until it goes to the next song. So what you might wanna do is move your cue over here a little early so that you can compensate for that, especially if you're trying to time it perfectly. But this is a great way to start a song, have it go the entire length of your song, and then start your next element so that your countdowns and your cues line up and start at the exact right time. If you're a worship leader, tech director, music director at a church, I wanna make it easier to help you make this happen. So head to fromstudiostage.com/PCLive to download one, my free Ableton template with that small little cue, and then my free Bome MIDI Translator Pro template that you can load on your other computer to make this happen super easily. So again, head to fromstudiostage.com/PCLive, completely free, then I'll send you my Ableton template as well as my Bome MIDI Translator Pro template. You're gonna have to purchase Bomes to make this happen, but you can at least get the template for free so that you in no time can be tracking your service elements and service times really quickly, automatically with Ableton Live. Thanks so much for watching this. See you guys next week. Take care. Bye-bye.